हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सिद्धगंगा एकेडमी यूट्यूब चैनल। सो टुडे विल बी डिस्कसिंग 14th अप्रैल करंट अफेयर्स। दीज आर द लिस्ट ऑफ टॉपिक्स दैट विल बी कवरिंग टुडे। देयर आर अराउंड 14 टॉपिक्स दैट विल बी कवरिंग टुडे। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। द फर्स्ट आइटम, बीहू बर्ड काउंट। सो बीहू इज अ बर्ड दैट इज फाउंड इन असम। सो दैट बर्ड काउंट इट इज डन एवरी ईयर। सो इट इज डन बाई द बर्ड काउंट ऑफ इंडिया। सो इट स्टार्ट ऑन 14th अप्रैल। सो बीहू बर्ड काउंट ऑफ इंडिया। So this is an NGO, Bird Count of India. This is an NGO which does this counting. And also one more fact we need to remember: Bohang is a Assam calendar. So Bohang Bihu, it's a Assam calendar which marks the beginning of the Assamese New Year. There are other two important festivals, that is the Kati Bihu and Kangali Bihu. So for the sake of examination, you have to remember Kati Bihu, Kangali Bihu, Bird Count of India. It's an NGO which counts the birds. And also it encourages people to watch the birds and report through pictures. Here you can see the Bihu bird count 2021 starts from 14th April up to 17th April. So let's mark it, let us mark the changing season by documenting the abundance and distribution of the birds of the region. See, observe the birds in your locality for 15 minutes as many times you like, so from 14 to 17th April, and upload the. So it is asking the citizens or the people of Assam to look at these birds and to upload those images of these birds. So these are the facts. So let's move on to the next item, that is the Raisina dialogue. So first let's understand what is Raisina Hills. So it's a powerful place where you find the Rashtrapati Bhavan and Secretariat building in New Delhi. So this is a place in New Delhi. So this you remember. So this is a dialogue, so which is basically meant for, it's an international conference on geoeconomics and politics. So it is a platform to discuss the economics and geopolitics. So it is organized by Ministry of External Affairs and the Observer Research Foundation. These you need to remember for the sake of examination. So it's been happening from 2016. So it is a similar to Shangri-La dialogue. Let's move on to the next item. This is currency chest. This was in the news because the security guard in Chandigarh, no, Axis Bank, he has stolen the around 4.04 crores from this. So because of this, it takes importance. So let's understand what is this currency chest. Currency chest, here you can see, it is the RBI stores the money meant for ATM and banks. So whatever the banks need for the sake of ATMs and their transactions, you know, this is maintained by RBI, so in the respective bank itself. So here the security has stolen this amount. Since RBI is in charge of these currency chests, so RBI has to take the responsibility for this, and it has to pay from its pocket. So you need to remember what is currency chest and who holds the responsibility for this and where the amount is stored. So these facts you need to remember. So let's move on to the next item, that is the e-Santa platform. Here you can see our Minister for Commerce, okay, Sri Piyush Goyal. He has inaugurated this e-Santa platform. It is basically an online portal for marine products. Since marine products play a greater role in our GDP, they contribute more to our GDP. So he has inaugurated this portal. What is the aim? Is to empower the aqua farmers. So what are the features of this? If you have to look, the farmers can sell their produce in e-Santa portal. It acts as a bridge between the buyer and the farmer. So there will be many difficulties between the buyer and the farmer. So farmer who needs to find the seller, and also the buyer needs to find the farmer. So this acts as a bridge between the buyer and the farmer. So it is available in these languages. This might be important for the sake of exam: English, Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, Odia, and Bengali. So here you can see these are most of the coastal places that takes preference here. So English, Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, Odia, and Bengali. These languages it is available as of now. And it is an initiative by the National Center for Sustainable Aquaculture. National Center for Sustainable Aquaculture. It comes under the Ministry of Commerce. So here we can see National Center for Sustainable Aquaculture is an arm of the Marine Products Export Depot, Development Authority. So this authority comes under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. This you have to remember. And if you have to know about the Indian fishery sector, it contributes around 1.07% of our total GDP, and it employs around 14.5 million people. So it's a big sector. So this should be any sufficient for the sake of exam. Next item is Balbir Singh. He died at the age of 88. Who is Balbir Singh? He was a former hockey player. He was from Punjab, basically. He was born in Jalandhar in the year 1932. And he was a member of the silver medal winning 1958 Asian Games hockey team. So this you need to remember. Next is about the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, the great personality whom everybody knows in our country. So he is known as the father of Indian Constitution. So to know facts about him, he was born in 1891 on April 14. So we celebrate Ambedkar Jayanti on April 14, and in 1956 he converted to Buddhism. He embraced Buddhism that we all know. His birthday is also celebrated as the Equality Day, and he was the founder of the Independent Labour Party in 1936. Some of the books, if you have to look, which he has written, first one is the Thoughts on Pakistan, Who Were the Shudras, Annihilation of the Caste. These are the books were written by Ambedkar. And he has got some international recognition also. In 2020, Canada decided to celebrate Ambedkar's birthday as the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar Day of Equality. And also British Columbia also in 2021 decided to celebrate as the Day of Equality. So if we have heard about the RBI, that is the Reserve Bank of India. He was also a key player in setting up this Reserve Bank of India. His book, The Problem of the Rupee and Its Origin and Its Solution, and it was presented to Young Commission. Later on in 1926, the Royal Commission on Indian Currency and Finances, also known as the Hilton Young Commission, it was based on the recommendation of this, the RBI was set up on April 1st, 1935. So this has been asked many times in the exam, so please do remember this fact. And it was Ambedkar's tireless effort due to which the Reserve Bank of India came into existence. Many people don't know about Ambedkar. They think only he was, he fought only for the sake of scheduled caste and scheduled tribes, but the fact is he was also an economist. So his book, The Problem of the Rupee and the Origin and its Solution, also helped establish the Reserve Bank of India. So let's look at the about constitution, few facts about the constitution. We all know about the making of the constitution. It took around how many sessions? 11 sessions, 165 days of discussion, and there were totally 299 members who were involved in the discussion. And to know specifically, it is the longest written constitution in the world. This also has been asked many times in the exam. It had around earlier 395 articles, 22 parts and 12 schedules. It basically provides six fundamental rights to the citizens, and it has a preamble. So preamble is the spirit of the constitution. So in a broader sense, we can know about everything in the preamble. So it talks about democracy, talks about social and religious and integrity of the nation. So all these keywords that are embedded in the preamble of the constitution. And our government and our Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji has established Dr. B.R. Ambedkar's International Center in 2017. And Panch Tirth was the initiative wherein the government of India is trying to develop, has developed five places just for the sake of remembrance. To know about these places, his birthplace, Mohow in Maharashtra, that is also developed as one of the places. And second place is his residence during the time of his studies in UK, that is also being developed. Third one is the Deeksha Bhumi, that is in Nagpur, Maharashtra, where he embraced the Buddhism. And fourth place, where he breathed his last breath, that is the Maha Parinirvan Sthal in New Delhi, and his memorial. So it's being built in Mumbai. Don't get confused. His memorial in Mumbai, he died in Delhi. So that is called the Mahaparinirvan Sthal in Delhi and Chaitya Bhumi in Mumbai. So these are the facts, important facts about Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. So next item, Minister for Commerce and Industry, Sri Piyush Goyal, has launched the Trade Facilitation App. So it was launched by the Commerce Ministry. So since he's the Minister for Commerce, so he launched it. So the basic aim of this app is to promote the ease of doing business, and it was developed by TCS. This fact you need to remember. Let's move to the next item, that is the Poshan Gyan. Poshan Gyan. Don't get confused with Poshan Abhiyan. It's the Poshan Gyan. So what is Poshan Gyan? Poshan Gyan is the National Digital Repository. Repository is a place where you store all the information. So it is basically an info repository on the health and nutrition, wherein persons who are in nutrition sector can get the information and materials just in the which gives them information about the feeding, antenatal care, adolescent health, anemia prevention, diet diversity. So all these things, those information will be stored in this repository and people can get the information from here. So it's being launched by Niti Aayog. You need to remember this, in collaboration with the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and Center for Social and Behavioral Change. Why it is important? Because the Global Hunger Index 2020 ranks India at the 94th place out of the 107 countries. So we need to improve on this factor. And we have, as I said, don't get confused. It is the Poshan Abhiyan. It is basically National Nutrition Mission. So it also aims to bring in the nutritional improvement in the children, lactating mothers and pregnant women. So it basically targets to reduce the stunting, anemia and low birth weight by 2%. You can here get the exact figures. And it is being funded by the fund is shared by the World Bank, 50%, and remaining by the government of India. So these facts you need to remember. Next item is the Yusuf Ali. Yusuf Ali Mosalian Vettil Abdul Kadev. So he's basically a UAE based Indian businessman. He has been awarded the prize. It's the Abu Dhabi's top civilian award, which is awarded to a businessman. And he is the founder of the Lulu Group. Lulu Group. It operates a chain of hypermarkets. You all know about the hypermarkets. We have so many hypermarkets in our country. So it is the retail facility carrying wide range of products under one roof, wherein you get even groceries also. So he heads this Lulu Group, and he's been honored by this award. And this Lulu Group, you know, it is being headquartered in Abu Dhabi. That is the UAE's capital. Next is the Kane Williamson. He has also been awarded the Richard Hadlee Medal. So Richard Hadlee also was a New Zealand cricketer bowler. So there is a medal being given to New Zealand cricketers by the New Zealand Cricket Board. So it is the fourth time he's getting this award. He got this award in 2016, 17 and 2019 also. So Kane Williamson is a New Zealand cricketer. Right now he's the captain of the New Zealand team. So next item, Ahar Kranti. So Ahar Kranti mission, it's being launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. So it is basically to spread awareness about the need of nutritionality, balanced diet to resolve the malnutrition, hunger and diseases of India. So you have to remember this Ahar Kranti mission. So it basically involves the teachers who will be trained and who in turn have to train the students and their families and ultimately the society. So teachers, they connect a lot to the students and their families. So in this way, this program, you know, targets the whole society and spreading the awareness about the health and family welfare. It's being launched by Vidyan Bharati, like Vidyan Bharati and Global Indian Scientists and the Technocrats Forum also, under the motto of Uttam Ahar, Uttam Vichar. Uttam Ahar means good food and Vichar means good idea. And one more fact you need to remember, the 2021 year is declared by the International Year of Fruits and Vegetables by the United Nations. Next item is the Global Food Policy Report. It is released by the International Food Policy Research Institute. So what is this report actually talking about? It is talking about the transforming world's food system. As we have heard, as we have experienced this during the time of COVID, that many people suffered from food. There we were not able to supply the food during the time of shortage because every business was shut. Even the small and big business, all of them were shut. People started going back to their villages and their earning had completely been shut off. And so we had to arrange the food for our people. So there was a lot of problem from where to cater this food. So system of food distribution, it is talking about. This report talks about how to handle these situations when there is a shortfall of food, when there is economy is in stagnant state. So it talks about the lessons learned and the way forward, how we need to move forward in such situations. So we have to remember the Global Food Policy Report 2021. It is being released by the International Food Policy Research Institute. And next and the last item for this day is Network Survey Vehicle. So this vehicle is being arranged by the, it's been sponsored by the National Highway Authority of India. So which is deployed, you know, to survey the vehicle, what is the quality of the national highways across the country. So this vehicle helps to, you know, like assess the quality of the highways across the country. So here we can see all the facilities that it has. It has the mobile line reflectivity. It has about GPS. You know, it has the digital camera. It has the digital acquisition system stored information. Then profiler, you can see here. So these are all the facilities that it has. So which will help help capture the information about the national highways and build a data system wherein it gives the information about the quality of the roads and what needs to be improved. So it will help the National Highway Authority of India to, you know, like take corrective measures and, for the national highways. So these are the items for today. So let's meet tomorrow with tomorrow's current affairs. Thank you.